Welcome to Yung Tuition. I am Yung. Let's continue discussing basic issues in meteorology in relation to formation of wind. Why is air pressure near the surface so stable compared with the surface temperature? That's my recent concern in my independent research on weather and climate. In my previous talks, I argued that air current or wind near the surface of Earth can be formed due to horizontal advection and diffusion when pressure gradient force is zero. I am so glad to have many comments on this new hypothesis. Today, I'd like to show some observational evidence in support of my hypothesis. Because the word observation has been abused by many climate researchers, it is necessary to emphasize that the evidence to be discussed is truly experimentally observable, rather than those intermodal comparison in climate modeling. So, are you ready? Let's go and have fun. By definition, air density is a number of air molecules per unit volume. Because air seems everywhere around us, it is not easy to measure time-dependent air density directly. Although one can connect a certain amount of air into a vacuum bottle at a time and then quantify it, as Keeling did for measuring CO2 in the atmosphere. So, in my previous talk, I suggested air temperature and air pressure be measured simultaneously in order to calculate air density instead. To my surprise, one viewer immediately sent me a plot of the daily air temperature and air pressure simultaneously recorded in his local weather station, as shown in this diagram. The vertical axis is air pressure in inch mercury, and the horizontal axis is air temperature in Kelvin. As you can see, the pressure was almost a constant when the air temperature had changed noticeably. Then I collect more data from the source he used. Here is a second plot of the pressure versus temperature. Obviously, the pattern is more complicated than the first one. Still, the variation in air pressure during this period of time, 48 hours, was still small. Between 29.8 and 30 inch mercury, or 1009 to 1016 in hectopascal. How about air density? I calculated air density based on ideal gas law, which can be simply written as this form, where rho is air density in kilogram per cubic meter, P, air pressure in hectopascal, and T, air temperature in Kelvin. You can use this simple formula to analyze your local air density too. Then I plot the dependence of air density on the surface air temperature. As you can see, air density decreases as air temperature increases, which can be well fitted by an isobaric curve. By zooming into the details, it is clear that the measured data points are located between two isobaric curves, but the two isobaric curves are very close, which implies the surface air pressure during this period of time was almost fixed, although the surface temperature had changed noticeably. This could happen when some places are sunny while other places are cloudy. Because of the departure of the air density distribution near the surface from uniform, local wind appears easily to equalize the surface temperature in that area, while the air pressure remains almost as a constant. To further illustrate such a natural phenomenon, I have downloaded more data from the Bureau of Meteorology in Australia, as shown in this diagram. This was measured at Melbourne Airport, and that was measured at the Brisbane Airport. As you can see, although the plot of air temperature versus air pressure looks irregular, the thermodynamical processes near the surface are mainly associated with the interplay of air temperature and air density, whilst the air pressure acts as a platform or as an air conditioner for air molecules to play and run. In this way, the surface temperature can hardly get extremely hot or cold. So it seems evident now that air molecules can move horizontally by means of advection and diffusion without air pressure gradient. I only mentioned diffusion in my previous talks, but this differential equation for advection and diffusion tells us all about what can inevitably happen whenever air density gradient shows up. Naturally, such local winds or breeze would not be too strong. Apart from acting as a local invariant or controller, atmospherical pressure can also settle down extreme non-equilibrium situations involving large scale and large quantity transportation of air masses globally by means of general circulation. In these cases, the variation of the surface air pressure in different places would be noticeably different. As a result, the variation in air pressure near the surface would be huge, as during a hurricane or typhoon, as shown in this diagram. By and large, the three variables near the surface, namely air density, air temperature, and air pressure, are confined to this 3D surface derived from ideal gas law. Unless air pressure change is apparent, the local air density and the local air temperature should be governed by a single isobarical condition, say 1,020 hectopascal in my place. Notice that both the observed minimum and maximum air pressure near the surface are shown. The recorded range of air pressure is 215 hectopascal, from 870 hectopascal to 1,085 hectopascal. In many a local area, and in most of time, however, the diurnal variation in air pressure is only a few hectopascal, almost a constant from this barometer. Here is another plot of air density versus air temperature near the surface. Compared with other diagrams I have shown so far, you can see the daily variation in air pressure is larger than usual, indicating a more apparent weather change. Still, the reciprocal dependence of air density on the air temperature can be seen whenever the air pressure becomes a constant temporarily. This implies that the Earth prefers to a stable air pressure near its surface. Probably, or even possibly, it is original design by the God, so that the surface temperature can be very hot. It is also important to point out that air pressure distribution near the sea level is different from that of the surface air temperature, as shown in these two synoptic charts. I choose them as two viewers from Ireland, Cumans. In their areas, high air pressure actually means high local temperature. Indeed, air pressure and air temperature are always out of phase near the surface, and hence the notion that the change in surface temperature makes the change in the air pressure seems superficial. At least, it omits such intermediate diffusion and advection discussed in this talk. To summarize briefly, it is revealed and confirmed that wind, or at least the breeze, can be generated in the absence of horizontal pressure gradient force near the surface. I hope to hear your comments and observations. Thank you for watching. Thank you for donation, which is sincerely appreciated. I wish I could spend more time to produce such public talks. See you next time.